In this video, we are going to talk about automated recon or reconciliation process. We will understand why they are so important and the advantages they offer, how and when we should implement and execute them, and much more. Before we start this video, I want to emphasize that this is how recons are used in most real projects, so please be attentive. So in our OLAP systems or any data mart or data warehouse, we get data from multiple source system, which in turn is loaded to our staging layer using an ETL process. Here we do not perform any transformation of data, and the data is directly replicated as it is from our source system. Now we do have a few options while loading our data into staging layer, like persistent or non-persistent staging layer, or creating a single table for every source dataset, or we can also merge similar dataset into a single staging table. If you want to know more about staging layer, I will drop a link to my video on it in the description section. So once our data is loaded into the staging tables, we perform transformations on it and we load it into our fact and dimension tables. We also create certain aggregate or calc tables on top of our transactional fact data to ensure optimal performance of our reports and dashboards. And instead of exposing the tables directly, we usually expose views or materialized views to the users so that if we change any underlying tables in the background, they do not have to perform any changes in their reports. We do have few other processes like housekeeping and error records feedback to source system, but we will discuss them in a separate video. So if we summarize, we get the data from different source systems, we load that into the staging layer. From there, we transform it into our facts and dimension tables. We aggregate our fact tables to create aggregate snapshots or our calc tables, which is consumed by users through reports and dashboards. Now, all these processes are usually batch processes that are run off business hours to minimize impact, which means the stage load may start around midnight and the report should be generated before 8:30 a.m. so that users can start using them right away. Now, a lot of time, users will look at the data and they will realize that the numbers are not correct. Either the recent data is not available or it's incorrect. So they will raise an alarm to the development or production support team stating that we have a problem. And then the development team will start looking into the data. They will realize what was the issue and then they will fix it. Once the issue is fixed, they will load the data again into our facts and dimension tables. They'll calculate the calc and they will refresh the reports, post which an automated communication will go to the users that the reports are ready. Here our approach was reactive. Teams started working after getting intimation from the users, and now while development team is fixing the issues, loading the data and refreshing the reports, the users have no option but to wait, which means crucial time and effort is being lost. Imagine we have around 600 reports that gets refreshed every night and around 150 users consume those reports. All of them have to wait till the reports are available. A better option is to introduce an automated data recon process post the data load, which validates and ensures that the data available in our data warehouse was loaded correctly and is usable. The reports and dashboards will only trigger post the successful confirmation that the recon was fine. Now, what will happen if the recon fails? Two automated emails will go out, one to the development and support team stating that recon has failed, what is the possible problem that should be acted upon immediately, and an email to the users that there was an issue with the data load, so report refresh will be delayed. This helps development team come in action immediately. They fix the issues, reload the data, and the reports are refreshed only once post the successful completion of the recon process. The users are well informed. The developers know immediately that they have an issue and what needs to be fixed, and the reports are loaded only once. And while the recons are very important, we also need to make sure they do not take too much time. So what should be covered in them? We usually compare the counts at high level and the aggregate value of measures. For example, the sales for last 3 days should be the same between the source system and the fact tables, or the number of trades that happened for the day should be the same between stage and fact table. If the discrepancy is greater than the threshold value, which is usually between 0.1 and 1%, we raise an alarm stating that we have a problem and the team starts performing the required actions. Now, what are the type of recons we can perform? We can either compare our source system data with our data warehouse data, or we can compare our staging layer data with the fact tables or the calc tables. Also, we can compare our fact tables with calc tables to ensure that our aggregation process worked as expected. Now let's talk about the high level architecture for this process. How can we design it? We can write a shell script, a batch process, or a Python script which calls the database using SQL Plus for Oracle or the respective database utility to fetch the queries we need to run against respective database for comparison. We will create and maintain a metadata table which will contain the list of queries we want to run, the database and schema where they should be run, and the name of the file where the query output should be stored. We will get all the data into files. We will perform a comparison between the appropriate files. If the difference is less than the threshold for all comparisons, we will generate a success email and we will generate a trigger to initiate the report refresh. But even if one of the comparison fails, we will send the two failure emails. Now let's look at this process in more detail. So first, we will have the header of our script listing the purpose of the script, the description, the tables involved, and stuff like that. Then we will connect to our DB using SQL Plus to get the contents of our metadata table into a flat file. Then we will run a loop for all queries in our database table. We will connect to the respective sources to get the output of these queries in our files. We will store them with the specific file names. We will have another table in our DB listing which file should be compared against which file. This process is completely metadata driven. If we need to add 5 more comparisons, we just have to add the queries and file details in these two tables and it will start that comparison automatically. Once the files are generated, we will compare them one by one to check if the variation is less than the threshold. If it is, we will move ahead. And if it is not the case, we will note down the files where we saw differences. Finally, we will create a summary of all such datasets where we observed an issue, and those will be sent to developers so that they already know where to start looking. But if everything was good, we did not have any differences whatsoever in any of the dataset, we will send a success email and the reports refresh will start. I hope this clarifies why recon is so important and how it is done in real projects. If you still have any questions, please drop in a comment and I'll be happy to help.